Ooh, what are these? I haven't seen this before. Now, these are willow trees. It's a different type. Oh, bayou. Got it. Probably should have done this while the sun was out. I was really expecting I'd be able to find a willow tree already. Unfortunately, it doesn't look like that's the case. Quick thing. How much juice? Yeah, I got plenty of juice. Because this is the mega jungle. Oh, there it is. Maybe there was something. Or there was one somewhere in this general direction. Oh, this is birch. Yeah, yeah. We wanted birch. Chop like one or two more. Is this it? No, that's a daisy. Did I actually get? Yeah, I got a birch sapling. Okay, we're good. Let's see. Oh, did I lose? Oh, I lost my waypoint. It's time to find my way home. In the dark, in the rain. Luckily, we've got a map. This would be so much worse otherwise. Passage time is fickle. As we age, it moves faster, but days can still crawl at a snail's pace. I mean, as far as I know, the main reason why it seems like time passes so fast as you're older is that your mind starts filtering out the noise. That the less new and interesting things that you do with yourself on any given day, the more likely time is to just pass really fast. Because after a certain point, the routine, you almost become kind of a living machine to it. And so the reason why time always passed so fast when you were a kid is because everything caught your attention. And also, when you're a kid, you don't really learn how to wait very well. Yeah, the days blur in isolation. Yup. That's why exercise, variety, mixing it up when you can, when and where you can, helps, I guess. Okay, did I put this stuff away? Yeah. I don't think we actually need the flower pouch right now. Oh, and I can put the cables away. I don't need them. Don't need them either. Okay, so let's grab a bunch of birch. Because there's probably some stuff I can do with birch. Though, honestly, a universal block reinforcer. That's interesting. So, first question, whoops. Do we want to just do regular birch, or do we want to do birch planks? I guess we should probably learn those. Big do I want this place to be? I guess we should definitely give ourselves a lot of space here. Just because. Reasonable amount. Is this huge? It is pretty big for just a basic greenhouse. Gives me a lot of space, though. Yeah, I think I'm gonna go for this. Maybe upper layers I'll make smaller. How did I even manage to get that out there? Heck if I know. I mean, you need to put more of the interdiction torches down. These guys know where I live. I don't like it. There are sun lamps that you can put down that more or less just torch zombies. Oops. Not you. Not there. Okay. These blocks are a lot easier to place. I can just go ham. Weird thing, just to go back to the concept of the passage of time and so on and so forth, the thing that's gotten me a little bit recently is some gold up in here. Let's actually get rid of this stuff. I don't think I'm actually going to use the birch. I thought I was going to, but I just don't think it's worth it. It's not for what I'm doing. Let's see, I'm gonna do this. Is that a reasonable distance in, or do we want to move it one more? Maybe I'll move it one more. There we go. Okay, let's get some magic wood up in here. Magic wood. Elevators. Oh, dang it. One problem with the magic wood elevator nonsense. Is I actually have to place these on a block. Otherwise they're not shaped right. Maybe there's a way to do it properly. But heck if I know. Alright. How do you... I thought it was just with an axe, you right-click and it, shifts. I guess I was wrong. Okay. Let me just do a magic plank. I'll do this. It's okay. What if? No, that looks hideous. Oh, you know what? Let's go Old Faithful. Let's get some terracotta up in here. Should match. Okay. It's a little gaudy, but I just want it to be kind of a sunny little entrance. Or actually, maybe I'd denote it based on floor. Nah, let's not do that. Alright. There we go. I guess the one other thing is we are going to have to... I'm going to have some of this looping over. Well, I don't know. We'll figure it out. Engineering hammer rotates. Huh, good enough. Okay. Alternatively, do I want to make the... Maybe this is what I use the birch for. Let's have the interior floor be made out of birch. Seems a lot better than this anyway. Let's see. Could make it out of some other things. But I think this will be okay. I said I was going to make a Botania farm upstairs, and I'm gonna spend like 2 episodes on YouTube just making a crazy greenhouse. I'm pretty okay with this. My only wish is that Dragon Quest Builders 2 is somehow, or 3, is as deep as this, so that I can get really deep into designing excessive greenhouses for no goddamn reason. Like, I don't know about you guys, I love Minecraft, but Dragon Quest Builders has something just slightly more to it. I think some of it is the story mode and some of it is the RPG mechanics. I know you can mod Minecraft so it has them, but, like, I really want to play more kind of sandbox builder games where your structures increase your stats. And DQB is the only one I've ever played that has something like that. Let's see. So I'm gonna need dirt. Maybe I leave that. Okay. I guess the other question I really am going to have to ask myself is, how the heck does anything work? How the heck am I going to farm? Yeah, it's a walkway around the crops. I could walk through the crops. I could do a number of things. I don't know. It's not the most space-efficient greenhouse. Okay, got them there. But I don't have an interdiction torch on this corner. There we go. I might also make, like, light posts somewhere. Dude, tell them about the mercurial eye. The heck is that? It's expensive, but it's not that ridiculous. What does it do? Do I still have a random jutting glass pane? Here it is. I forgot about this one. Makes building easier. All right. So what am I missing? Bricks and red matter. rich. Weps. Oh, while I'm here, chuck those in. Let's chuck the essence in. Let's throw away some of this garbage. The terracotta. Get rid of that. I don't know what I'm going to do on the second floor yet. We'll get there when we get there. But I should work on automating the endoflame and actually getting this thing working. Ooh, red matter is expensive. Eventually I'll have a whole stack in here, but... Okay, so how does this thing work? Okay, you set it to what you want it to place. Okay. Part of my problem that I'm running into is that every time I play this, every time Alexa... Okay, change mode. Extension, creative pillar... How does extension mode work? Okay. This is why I don't like diving into mods that I'm not ready for, because now I'm lost. Oh well. I'm gonna need another Klein Star. There we go. Let's chuck you back in here. Okay, so here's how the Klein Star works. Well, let's see if I can do this. Okay, Mercurial Eye, except for we want to do framed glass pane. Okay, so chuck this in here, switch this out. So I have it on... Oh, whoops. Extension classic, transmutation, pillar, creation mode. Okay, so this just gives that to me. That's not that helpful. Extension mode. Nope. Okay. I mean, it's certainly interesting. It worked better earlier. Extension, transmutation, pillar mode. What if I do... What the... Well, I mean, on one hand, this is wildly inconvenient and not what I wanted to do. On the other hand, this is going to make making things outdoors real interesting. I do have it charged to full power, this is true. Oh, I got the wrong thing. What if I try now? See, the problem is it just makes these really ugly pillars, so I don't think pillar mode is what I'm looking for. Probably extension. Okay, so can't be pillar mode. Extension classic? Huh. Well, it's doing things. Okay, so maybe if I did that? No. Yeah, the problem is I needed to put these blocks down. Not on the sides of it. It worked really well for extending this ring around. That worked amazingly. But I think the Klein Star might not be what I'm looking for otherwise. I mean, creation mode itself is super handy. Just because it'll do exactly what I needed. Almost exactly what I needed to do. And then it gets kind of weird. I don't know. I think it's good for big frameworks. I'm not sure if it's good for anything else. And that's okay. Yeah, I can try and make something entirely out of it later. Maybe? I put down the initial layer and then extend it with creation mode. The only problem is I am going to use the regular glass panes for the next section. So, I don't know. One way or another, I'm also in the wrong spot. Because this is the second floor. Okay, so next order of business is actually digging an underground passage between both of these sections. And then hooking up one more elevator down in here. Okay. Changed all my hotkeys. Okay, controls, key, B. Because I only want it to be shape edit. Alright, next up is C. That would explain why my FOV keeps zooming in every single time. Okay, there we go. That's not really what I wanted it to do. Because I'm on the wrong mode. But, grand scheme of things, it's okay. There we go. That's a lot more controlled. All I want to do is have a lot of the necessary bits underground. Shoot. And I really wanted to avoid that. This shovel is way too damn strong. Okay, whatever. Easily replaced. it this? Yeah, it's this. Okay, do I still have any more elevator blocks? No. Well, let's put away a bunch of these. If I can use the Mercurial Eye for that stuff at the very least, it's not so bad. So once you have a row of them, shouldn't they follow the row then? Maybe? I don't know. It seemed very uncontrolled. And trying to learn how to get it to work properly was taking just about as much time as putting it down normally. I think it'll be best for transmutation, is the real answer. There we go. Okay, so now we can get down in here. And freely explore. Let's just put that there. Okay, this should mess up any monster that comes into this base. Yeah, I'll look up how to specifically use the Mercurial Eye. But it's not like a huge rush project. That's obnoxious. Grass spreads though, so I shouldn't have to worry about this. Okay, so we want to do... I need some fruit punch. I'm getting hungry. Okay, yeah, grass is already spreading. So first and foremost, now that we're done making my ridiculous sort of greenhouse, I realize there's still a lot left to it, but the ground floor is kind of the most important part. Wasn't there an old trick where you could use the Mercurial Eye to transmute walls into glass to find ore veins? That's hilarious. I'm probably going to use it later for evil by transmuting the earthen parts of the north into wood. probably that. We might change it into something else. Maybe obsidian. Transmute the entire country into gravel. Maybe. I can't burn the world. Sponge. Oh, man. I probably shouldn't, but it'd be really funny. Okay. Well, one way or another, I want to look into the Endoflame. Let's actually do Britannia. So, we've got the Endoflame. Cool. As the flower requires dropped items, an open crate, and some sort of output limiter, a timer for a pressure plate would be ideal for it. I should be okay on that one. Maybe. There's also hydrangeas, but I'm not doing that. So do you just drop the resource onto them? If there are planters. Like a flower pot? Because what I'd like is to have this thing planted in a block slightly up. Okay. Mana pool. Minecart with mana pool. Diluted mana pool. Fabulous. Mana pool. What's so fabulous about it? It uses shimmer rock. How do we get Shimmer Rock? I think we need to do something fancy for that one. So I'll leave it later. A floating flower? Oh, here we go. Okay, we're looking for floating end of flame. So, it looks like it's just any kind of floating flower. Okay, pasture seeds. So, looks like chicken before the horse, we should leave. We should wait for a bit. Song slaps. Chip to the Necrodancer, Sticks and Stones 4-1 Remix. Effectively, Chipsel did a really lovely Crypt of the Necrodancer remix album, and it is so good. Alright, I'm gonna have to go find my living stone, so I'll go work on that one. I guess I could make more. I should still have the pure daisy, yeah? Yeah. Maybe this is actually a job for upstairs. Some birch planks up in here. Okay, then we're gonna need stone. Just regular boring stone. I think this works. That should work. I'm just gonna leave that there. Okay, let's see. I had some living rock. Let's go down. I mean, I guess what I could do... because we have these alchemical chests, I could just straight up chuck these into the universal storage. I could. I think I'll chuck those into the universal storage. Some of this, it's gonna get real messy if I start just doing that, though. I'm not sure if I want to get that messy yet. Nope, that's not it yet. Okay. I want to go back here. Toss the living rock in. We want to make a mama pool. Ah. Okay, regular mama pool. Bam. And we want to... I'm just going to pull the guide back out. I'm so lost. Okay. Generating mana... generating flora, flowers, name would imply generate mana, usually consuming resources do so. All generating flora, like their functioning brethren, can hold a small amount of, small internal buffer of mana. Mana? I don't know. Okay, automatically output to the closest mana spreader. Mana spreader is the single most important tool botanist needs to manipulate mana. Block shoots mana from point A to point B. It faces a cardinal direction when placed, but sneak right-clicking it with a wand of the forest on a face points it elsewhere. It can be aimed at other blocks in bind mode. The mana spreader, as seen with the wand of the forest, held... oh, I see. It's a small internal buffer of mana, which will get filled by generating flora bound to it. Flowers when placed auto-bind to the nearest spreader. This buffer can be viewed by hovering over the spreader with wands... okay. Pulling one of the forest makes nearby spreaders display aiming beams. How, hovering over a spreader highlights its target. Sparkles show where the mana loss begins to occur. As long as the target of the spreader can accept mana, that is, contain mana and isn't full, the spreader will repeatedly fire mana bursts, travel to their destination, and transfer mana to it. The spreader will only fire another burst when the last one hits its target. Furthermore, a mana burst will start suffering mana loss after a small amount of time. This can be seen as the burst's appearance as it thins at that point. Applying a redstone signal to a spreader will pause its firing a burst. Got it. Mana spreader. So we just need a petal, gold, and some living wood. Ah! So if I hit it with a piece of wool, it'll sleeve it so it doesn't make as much noise. Okay, so in that case, we might want to get some more pure daisies here. Heck, I might want to even figure out how to auto-place this junk.